Bobby. Get 'em.
It's a Brave Talk Radio exclusive here on TonyEmehel.com. So let's join the conversation. It's already in progress with author Colin Tate, Latonja Worsham, and yours truly, Toni Emehel.
One of the things that you said is that the chameleon is a gatherer of information. And since we live in such a socially aware society now, where everything is posted on social media, I find out a lot about what's going on in people's lives. I find out more of what's going on in folks' lives on social media than I do when I'm sitting around in a conversation with them. And is that a watering hole for the chameleon?
Well, that is a start, but he has to get to the emotional aspect of what you're looking for in a partner. And he made a statement, the guy who I interviewed as chameleon, he made such a profound statement one time where he dated a woman who was very, very promiscuous. She was in a strip club. She was, she used to have sex for money back in the day. And I told her, I said, why are you even perceiving that there could be a future? He said, because even a prostitute doesn't want to feel like a prostitute. And I thought that was so profound and said that, because at the end of the day, no woman wakes up and says, I don't want to fall in love. I don't want to meet the man of my dreams. When you were 18, 17, 16, you did not say, I don't ever want to get married. I don't ever want to fall in love. Now, when I meet women who say they don't want that, it's because life has taught them that they don't believe it's going to happen. That's why they say it. But back to what you said about that chameleon, on social media, you're only getting a few things. He has to get the emotional things of what you're looking for. He wants you looking at his page when you lead a conversation. He wants you talking to your girlfriends about him after a good phone conversation. That's what he wants, and he knows how to do it. He knows that, ooh, that was a good conversation. She's going to be talking to me about her friends after we get off this phone call. She's going to take our first date and make it the Super Bowl. That's what I tell women. Don't go to Super Bowl on the first date. A first date is just that, just to see if there should be a second one. A second date should be if there should be a third one. Don't make it Super Bowl and think you're walking this guy down the aisle. But guess what? The chameleon doesn't mind it. He doesn't mind you thinking you're going to walk him down the aisle, because he knows he's going to be on witness protection in the next month or two. So he has no issue with it. So the thing is that time. And if he seems like everything is matching up, let the time see if his words match his action. That's always the best defense is time.
That's interesting, because on the flip side of that, I've dated a chameleon back in the day. And, you know, when we talk about the fact that he is a gatherer of information and he likes what I like and he does what I do, you know, women have to also be careful. And I know I throw a lot of the cautions to the wind out there, but making sure, too, that he's not a pedophile. He's not a murderer. I mean, my sister lived with somebody for years that was just a roommate, and all of a sudden the police knocked on the door and said he was arrested for murder for killing his girlfriend years ago, not to mention a possible rapist. So we're talking about somebody who was very influential, very charismatic, you know, the chameleon. He liked what I liked. He cared about what I cared about. And, yeah, you better believe it. I was telling my girlfriend he was all that in a bag of chips at one time.
One of the statements the chameleon says he loves to hear after two or three phone calls, he tells me women always say, gosh, why are you, how are you single? And he says he just laughs every single time.
That burns my bitch.
Yeah, it does.
Same here. Yeah, one of the other characteristics you noted about the chameleon is that he's narcissistic.
Yeah. See, the chameleon also has insecurities. Like myself, I had insecurities, and we look for the women to make us feel good about ourselves. We look for the women to build our self-esteem. A lot of times when you see men who are older, no kids, great careers, and they're still single, there's some still narcissistic tendencies there, because they're still looking for a relationship of women to fill a void in their life. And that's what I used to do. I used to look for women to fill that void, and I kept picking badly every single time. And when I finally decided, you know what, I'm ready for a loving and caring relationship, and yet I was still picking badly, I had to do the hard work, talk to God, figure out what I was doing wrong. And he showed me, he says, you're picking women based off of your own insecurities. I think I'm a good-looking guy, but I was teased for having acne when I was 12 and 11. I mean, you know, a lot of us had that at that age, but, you know, you grow out of it. But that still stuck with me. I still saw myself as the kid in the mirror with acne. And so I would look for women who fit a certain look of attractiveness to make me feel good about myself. And here's the ironic thing when you are leading with your insecurity. When you do meet a great man, or in my case, you meet a great woman, and she's not making you, how can I put this? There are certain women I would date that made me feel like I need to offer them not just Georgia, but the world. I need to offer them everything. I need to throw the whole kitchen sink to show that I'm good enough. And when I would meet women who were healthy and said, you know what, Colin, you don't have to do all that. First thing I thought in my mind was, okay, I know something's wrong with me. And if you don't think something's wrong with me, something's got to be wrong with you. And that was a lot of unhealthiness I found with myself and a lot of women I interviewed who would date men based off their insecurity. When they would meet a great guy that didn't make them jump through all those hoops, they automatically thought something's wrong with that guy.
I got a question, though, for you, Colin. And that is, ma'am, how do men respond to the fact that you're giving away all these goods of information?
Oh, boy. Let me tell you, I did an interview yesterday with a young lady in South Africa, somewhere, I don't know. But either way, there were live men on the show, and one of the things I talked about, she read, she was enamored with the Baby Boy chapter, and she pretty much admitted that's who she would date, baby boys. And she told me that I had no idea men faked orgasms. And the phone lines in that country called and said, why are you telling women this? What is your agenda? Who are you trying to set people up? Why are you doing this? So to answer your question, yes, I get a lot of negative feedback, but that also lets me know this is working. No disrespect to all the great relationship experts out there, all the relationship books out there, but there's just nothing else written where you get it from these multiple men's mouth from the cradle to grave about what they do, how they do it, and why they do it. So, yeah, I catch it.
We appreciate you answering that.
hilarious. So we'll move on to the next type of man, the online player. And I noticed that you said, don't get the online player confused with being catfished. And I'll have to admit, that was the first time I saw the word being catfished. I had never heard of that term. But yet, Tress knew what it was right away. So let's talk about the online player, the differences of the online player and being catfished, and what's really going on there.
So, you know, the term catfish is popular from the MTV show Catfish. And basically what it is you have someone who you connect with somebody online, but for whatever reason you guys can't meet, you can't Skype. You know, they always have these excuses every time y'all decide to meet up, or, you know, my house burned down, my mother died, or somebody's sick. It's all these excuses, and then you find out that the person picture that you see is not who they actually are. It's, you know, some other person behind the photo that has low self-esteem or issues with their looks, so they present somebody who you think that you would like. So that's what being catfished is. But see, the online player, he uses social media to meet all the beautiful women he wants. He no longer has to go into the bars and to the clubs. It's right there at his fingertips. And I may have said this to you ladies on an earlier show, but every man is, well, let me say this. Men are not as confident as you think to approach beautiful women off the street. Let me just clear that up right away. I'm sure each of you ladies may have a situation where a man has stared at you at the grocery store, stared at you at the club, stared at you at the gas station, but just didn't approach you. And the reason men don't approach is because every man at some point, whether it's me, whether it's Brad Pitt, whether it's Barack Obama, whether it's Idris Elba, every man has had a woman, as we approach her, cut us down. I mean, just rip us to shreds. It's like our heart is in our head. And I'm sure you ladies have seen some friends. You may have been guilty yourself. I don't know. But you may have seen that women just give men that look like, why are you even in my space? So when that happens to a man, it hits his self-esteem, his self-confidence. So the online player can approach all these same beautiful women without experiencing any of the same rejection. So he can approach this beautiful woman in Detroit, and she doesn't respond, that's it. He can approach another woman, and she doesn't respond, that's it. But he doesn't send her a note, and then she sends him back a note saying, what are you doing talking to me? You are just, you're, he doesn't get that. All she does is just doesn't respond. So with the online player, it's a big numbers game of him approaching beautiful women.
Interesting.
Yeah, I was getting ready to say, I was that woman that would cut him down back in the day.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you just couldn't step to me, and I didn't want you to feel like you could. And that largely came from being hurt in the past. So, you know, a guarded woman will do that. And like you said before, hurt people hurt other people. That was me. And I actually remember, you know, my mission at one point in life was to go out and make all the men I could feel the way that I had been made to feel in a relationship.
Yeah.
You know, what woman's voice.
I'm glad you said it, because there's some women out there who don't understand why men aren't approaching them. And I tell them, if you have that, if you're walking fast or you have that look on your face, that stoic expressionist look on your face, it sends a signal to us that says, leave me alone or I'm going to bite your head off. But then on the other side, they say the only men that approach them are just guys that just want sex. And I said the reason they do that is because they already know there's no long-term commitment, because they can see the work already that has to be done. So that's why they're like, you know what, I'll approach you because I'm not planning on being in your life that long anyway. As opposed to the men that don't approach you, they look at it as, you know, I want to get to know her, but based off the look she's giving, it's going to be a lot of work. She's going to bite my head off. I'm moving on.
That's right. And you are so right, because everybody wants the benefits of eating that cake, but they don't want to put the time in to make the cake.
That's right. Mm-hmm.
Look, like, it's funny. My wife cuts guys down when they approach her, but she doesn't understand why men just keep approaching her. And I said, because you have an approachable look. You're always smiling. You look, your energy says, I'm not going to cut you down. But you take a NeNe Leakes, just for to use an example. You look at her, she's in a bad day. Men know. You don't even have to know she's famous. You can just tell by that same look. I don't care if I approach this lady with respect. She's going to bite my head off. And they leave it alone.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I can attest to that. I've been told that not just by men. I've been told that by women. And it's all good.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's all good, and I have continued to grow.
Hey, I know that's right. My mother used to tell me to wipe that smile off my face personally, because she said it used to draw too much attention to myself.
You know, I've heard it said, you know, just in someone who thought they could be a suitor, that you look like you're just too high maintenance.
I want to be clear. I want to be clear why my mother said that. She said that because of her own, when we talked back before about the generational things, because she had her own bitterness, you know, her own bitterness about men as well.
Good point.
You know, so
that's what the online player does, ladies. He learns how to manipulate social media. He will create his page to be a very exciting individual, like the gentleman in my book. It was so interesting. He had all these multiple pictures of himself, but then there were some pictures of him skiing. There were pictures of him skydiving. There's a picture of him in Africa, and none of those pictures were him. The picture of him in Africa was just him in some field in Alabama. The picture of him skiing and skydiving was just a white man with all this equipment, and he was right. So you can't tell who it is. You know, you have no idea. And so he learned, he had a specific note that he would send out to women. And I'm going to tell you why I have it memorized, because I tried it out myself to see if it would work, and with my wife's permission, but we wanted to see if it worked. It was the first. We both got on and signed up, and we wanted to see if what this guy was saying was true. So the note said, first of all, I think you have an absolutely gorgeous smile. I love some of the things you have to say in your profile, blah, 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 blah. I would love to know you better. And what he would do, he would look at the picture and copy and paste that
same note to every single woman. And it's like a numbers game, he said. He said, you know, if I, he said, I'm in sales, Colin. If I send out 100 notes, I know just from from sales, I'm gonna get 50 messages back. And I said, well, what about reading all those profiles? He said, I don't read the profiles. He said, when I get a message back, that's when I read the profile. So he had that thing down to a science.
Yeah, that's sales for y'all, right? And so, you know, it makes me think about the fact that a lot of these different people, even Toni, you know how we see a lot of times people have various profiles. You know, like I saw a woman once who had her face on her husband's spot, and I thought to myself, your husband got other pages. So, you know, what makes you think that you blocking somebody? You're not really blocking. He's going to do what he wants to do. And, yeah, I did say husband, you know, because a lot of people aren't playing games, in other words, you know, several Twitter pages, several Facebook pages. So trust me, if he wants to, a man in general, wants to reach out to a woman or to be reached, he will find a way.
Yeah. And social media makes it very easy.
Good stuff. Good stuff.
I guess all I want to add is that, you know, at the end of the day, this book is just to be of service to women. And, you know, I tell men it's not a male-bashing book because there are a lot of great guys out there. It again, it's just to empower you with the knowledge to recognize a good man from a bad one before you invest too much of your time and heart. That's it. But once you read this book, I've had women tell me they can't even watch romance movies the same way. They can't even listen to their friends. issues with men anymore because the light has been shown. They can't. I have women that say they've lost friends because they can't entertain the crap anymore because they know the reason. So this book, ladies, your power will be back in your hands. I promise you.
That's good. And tell them again, Colin, how they can get your book.
Yes, they can go to my website. It is isthisyourman.com. My book is available on Amazon, Kindle, Nook, and on iTunes.
Wow.
It's a wrap. We'll talk with you next week, going a little deep, a little wider, and we're going to talk about really, you know, if you find yourself in a relationship and you are in love with one of these men, what do you do? And we'll also talk about, you know, how did they get that way, and how do you rehabilitate that mind that causes him to want to be a BS? How do you rehabilitate that to pull him out of being a baby boy? So stay tuned, and we'll check back in with y'all next week.
Yeah.
She's like, yeah, what she said.
You are listening to Brave Talk Radio at TonyEmehel.com. Today's broadcast has been brought to you by Next Level Plus Project Management and Business Consultants. Learn more about how Next Level Plus can help you solve the right problems and seize the right opportunities by calling 704-780-2997 or visit their website at nextlevelplus.org. You are listening to Brave Talk Radio at TonyEmehel.com.